If you've been following along with our 2024 expedition season, you might have noticed that ROV Hercules received a couple of upgrades over the off-season, including a shiny new manipulator arm. Come with us and learn the ins and outs of this fascinating piece of technology.
Hi, my name is Josh Chernoff. I'm the ROV Operations Manager here at OET, and one of the things that we integrated over the last winter was a new Schilling Orion radar arm. So this is a rate function arm that we run off a subalonic valve pack, and we're actually running each of the functions on proportional valves that we can control up in the control van. Kind of similar to the old arm that we used to have on here. Maybe some of you remember the ISE Magnum that we had on here from the very beginning. We finally had to get to a point where we had to replace that arm. But we're really happy so far with this arm. We actually got to use it for the first time in the last dive. So it's kind of a standard arm that's been around for a long time. It'll be an awesome tool for us.
Hey, Dan, is this a good time to ask you a question? I was hoping you can talk a little bit about the new arm.
The name of it is Orion. It's primarily made out of aluminum extrusion. To be technically correct, it's a 6 degree of freedom, 7 function rate arm. The Orion is a lot simpler, stronger than the craft arm. If I had to do an analogy, it would be a lot closer to an excavator or a backhoe. So it's quite beefy. It was designed to be maintained and repaired with an adjustable wrench and a hammer. Currently at the moment, it still has the standard giant 4-finger jaws on it. So typically the Orion arm is used for construction. So it's meant to do exactly what we're doing with it, come up and grab onto things. We can be a lot more precise with this manipulator versus the one that used to be on Hercules. We can move it fast or move it slow, have lots of power or just a little power, which enabled us to do something like we did yesterday with put the tip of the giant 4-finger intermeshing jaw on a 25 millimeter aluminum puck to engage the trigger on the gas tight, which would have been challenging at best with the Magnum manipulator we had.